Hi everyone, welcome to my YouTube channel. Today I am here to discuss a new topic called interactive filter. So what is the interactive filter and why we need the interactive filter? Interactive filter is mostly applicable on this your homepage or your dashboard for reporting purpose. So let me show you that how the interactive filter looks like and then we can build from the scratch, okay? So if you see example in interactive filter incident. This is the home page I was seeing these the service not provided out of box. So we can able to see any report and interact with that report or not first. Okay, so let's see. So you can see this is that data which is showing that all these details, and these are the interactive filter which is created by service now out of box. So once you click that, these all are that, once you click that, all groups with this, any of these filter, it will reflect on your left side the data. So let's say I click that application development, right? And today, and I think I need to be, so once we click that, definitely it is reflecting on this below section, okay? I'll show you that way. How we can make that interactive filter today. Okay, so let's go to first create one home page. So I'm creating one page for my case. So go to the home page admin, and in the pages I'm creating one home page for myself, and then that home page I'll create one report and add that my home page Rohit. So for the example I'm putting this is that page name, okay, and so once we see that view home page, it doesn't have anything, so it will be simple blank, okay. So you can see this my home Rohit is blank right now. We'll create one report. To create the reports, we have to go to the reports and click that create new. So we'll create one report and add that report here, and also add the interactive filter to interact those things with the ServiceNow. Okay, let's see. So I'll create a report on the incident table, which is active incident. So active incident, I'll put the table, and table name is incident. And go to the next, and I will maybe not like that. I need that line wise. So normally go to the next and I'll put the filter as active is true, and run this filter. Let's see how many incident is active. And in the column I will put that assignment group. So basically this assignment group is already available. Maybe configuration item. Let's put that configuration item. And save this. So this report I created for my own purpose called active incident, and this incident, all the active incident which is present to the service now will show here. The configuration item, there are few configuration item which have I think blank, and few have that configuration item, right? So this report is created. Now I need to add this report. Let's see how many record is there right now. 38 record is there. So we'll put that one condition that assignment group is not empty and configuration item is not empty. Let's see then how many record is available through this report. So in this case, I think few records we are seeing, almost 14 records we are seeing. So that is my perfect filter for in that case. I'll create the interactive filter on the configuration item. So let's add to my dashboard or maybe homepage. Let me add that. Okay. Share. Add to dashboard. Homepage. And I will put here. Add. So let's refresh this one. I think this report is added here. You can see. And all these 14 record, whatever we are seeing is visible here. Now I want to create one interactive filter called configuration item, so that based on the configuration item, this record or this report will be interact. Okay, so let's do that. So if you type the filter under the report admin, there is a filter called interactive filter. Let me show you that interactive filter on the homepage admin. We'll create a new interactive filter here. Okay, it's taking time. So we'd say that this interactive filter name is my, so we'll fit that as a configuration item. We can do the few things. I'll show you that. I think the priority is added. Yeah, so first we'll create one reference fields, reference, then CI, maybe Rohit, putting my name. So this is that interactive filter. You can select the multiple, but I am putting that as a single input, and the table name is, we are actually will create that CI, right? So we have to, the table, reference table will be configuration item. Okay, so we put that table. So if you want to add some condition, because you can add that, otherwise it will be show that all this CI. So I would say that I can put anything, but I'm not putting any right now. So you can state, operational state, we can put that is not deployed, is not retired. Okay, so we are putting some condition. So our interactive filter is pointing to this CI table, but it needs to be interact with that report, or this is the report, right, which is actually in the incident table, right? So we'll put that condition also here. First we'll go to, there is a module called interactive filter reference, click the new and choose that table name as incident. Did it choose incident at time? So it choose the incident table, and now we are actually mapping with the configuration item, right? So incident table's configuration item should be matched with the interactive filter. We'll choose that configuration item and save that. So our interactive filter is basically ready for the incident table. So CI Rohit, which is actually checking that CI or interacting with the CI for the incident table, right? So let's add this interactive filter here. Add content. Sometimes it takes some time to adding some content. So let's wait for a few minutes. I think it will be we can be able to add that one. So these are, I think, the configuration item. You can see the example configuration item. So let's go to this interactive filter. And our interactive filter is basically a reference filter. And this is the CI row, it is the interactive filter name. And click in the right side so that it will be present to right side. Now the interactive filter is added, and you can see that all the CI name, which is as per our filter, is showing right now. We need to click that edit options here, edit widget, and follow interactive filter. This needs to be checked and save that. Okay, so now you can see the configuration item in this report is two things. One is the SAP sales, another is the SAP controlling. So if you want to add or see that some data basically to interact with this one, you just need to be select the SAP controlling, so that once you click the SAP controlling, all the SAP controlling record will be present. So you can see that it start interacting with this interactive filter with there. Okay, once you click that all, again it will be back to this all the record. So that's how you can build that interactive filter. Okay, for example, we are talking about that this one, SAP sales distribution. We can filter on this one and start filtering or start interacting in the right in the left side report. Okay, that's how we can interact with our report. Okay, so this is all about the reference field, right? But if I want to interact with the priority, how we can do, because this priority is the sixth choice list, right? So for that, we can create one interactive filter called choice. We can do that one also. So click that new option. And we need to be create one choice. So we are creating one filter on this table called it started loading. Yep. So here I have to choose the incident because I am going to interact with the incident table. Click that incident and click that field as priority. Where is that? I think I need to be, no, can I scroll down? Oh, it is somehow not taking. Let me do one. Okay. So priority, right? I have to choose that priority. Okay, and now this name should be also, I should be able to put that name here also. So our choice interactive filter is created. You can see there is an option called multiple input. So if I choose the multiple inputs, you can choose or you can select the multiple record, or if you put the single, will only be able to, you will only be able to select that single input. So I think we missed that. So let me again choose that field. So it little bit slow. Let's see. Okay, it's refreshing. Maybe meanwhile I can add this multiple interactive filter call choice priority Rohit, and this is the right side our filter. For single, I am doing that for single, okay? I am making that changes. So the field should be priority and it should be updated. So people can be selected, you can see the people can select multiple. Instead of that, we are doing that single one. So once we refresh that, I think every here it should also reflect. So now our two interactive filter is added. One is the CI Rohit, which is able to, we can select any of the CI. If we select any this unnecessary CI which is not present to this report, it will be not be present, right? And second is the priority, which is choice types. We can add that definitely for sure. For example, I want to see all these high incident. So this is the only one high incident. If I choose the critical, there are few critical one. So that's how the interactive filter is work. If you want to go through, there are few more that cascading filter. If you see the cascading filter is nothing but I just show you that one to one, right? It is separately working with each other, but cascading filter is that it will be like AND condition, priority and CI Rohit, priority and CI. So that in that case we need to be do that cascading filter. Okay, so that's all about for the interactive filter. I am just simply repeating. You just need to be create one home page, and in this home page you need to be add this report, and you need to be create that interactive filter in that home page admin, and the type should be choose based on that, either this is the choice list or this is the reference. And once you create those, and you just need to be add here, and you have to be click that edit option and make sure that this there is a interactive filter checkbox there that follow interactive filter that needs to be checked, and then you can start using it. That's all about that. Thank you very much for watching my video. Have a great day.